The topic for today's video is decisiveness in game. Now, if I were to tell you that it's important to be decisive with a girl, you'd probably yawn, nod your head, and say, I already know that. However, what I'm talking about is a specific type of decisiveness that comes up over and over again in game and can give you a massive change in your results. It's actually a question I get asked by students over and over again, these various sort of topics they ask me. And the answer is always the same, which is, it doesn't matter, which is a frustrating thing for a student to hear. They ask me a question, I'm like, it doesn't matter. Ask me another question, it doesn't matter. And the fact of the matter is, it oftentimes doesn't matter which decision you make in a set, but it does matter that whatever decision you make it absolutely. There's a great story I once heard. They said, you can think about making love to a woman before you make love to her, you can think about it afterwards. But when you're there in that moment, you just make love to her and you fuck her as hard and as well as you can. And there's a lot to be said for that, right? You can think about the consequences, think about what may go wrong before, think about what may go wrong after. But once you've committed to that action, you commit absolutely and you just do that action the best that you can and you don't waffle, you don't falter. There are many times in game where that is the key decision, not what you do. I'm gonna give you basically a laundry list of examples. Many of these are things you will have seen in your own game, and many of these, hopefully, are things that will help you to clear up issues that you are having.
Walk on the road. Walk right side, safe. Walk left side, safe. Walk middle, sooner or later, get the squish, just like grip. Here, karate, same thing. Either you karate do yes or karate do no. You karate do guess so. Just like grip. Understand?
Number one question I get asked. Guy goes into a set with guys and girls. He says, do I talk to the guys or do I not? Here's the thing. It doesn't matter, okay? You can either go in, talk to the guys, take the frame that guys are just ugly girls, be friendly with everybody, get to know them, and just be slightly cooler than the guys. Take your time, build the set, treat the set as your social circle, make everybody like you, and then talk to the girl you want. That's one way to handle a mixed set, and it's a perfectly valid way. In fact, it's maybe the highest percentage way if you're going for a particular set and you want to get that one set. If your criteria for success is get the set rather than have a great night, that's probably the highest percentage play many, many times, especially if your social skills are quite good. However, the other way to go is go direct on the girl, ignore the guys, deal with the fact that you're probably gonna get some social blowback, and recognize the fact that that social blowback actually builds your value. The fact that the guys are giving you shit and you disacknowledge them makes you more alpha, gives you that attractiveness, and sometimes you can get some of the most attraction you've ever seen with a girl from these type of sets, because she'll be so impressed and so overawed by the fact that you're able to go in and go above and beyond the guys without even having to acknowledge them. Now, where guys go wrong in this situation is when they try and split the difference. If they go in fairly nice to the guys and then all of a sudden screw them over and cut them out, the guys will turn on them and will be very upset because they feel like they've been sort of shortchanged or they've been treated in an underhanded way, they've been gypped. And even maybe worse is to go in completely fuck all the guys, who the hell cares, and then once they get some resistance, be like, oh, I'm sorry, are you with them? I'm sorry, hey, nice to meet you, and then bow down to the guys. Neither one of those works, okay? What you must do, you must make a strong decision. Either absolutely treat the guys as ugly girls, be friendly with everybody, or decide I am the most important thing going on here and whatever else I will deal with if I have to. Those are the two decisions. Make absolutely one, absolutely the other. Anything in the middle will not work. Second question, do I go direct or do I go indirect? Again, it doesn't matter. You can do a great set direct, you can do a great set indirect. However, if you waffle, you are fucked, okay? You can go in and say, you are fucking hot. You are a tall beauty, I wanna fornicate you, as a good friend of mine says. You can go completely direct, completely over the top, or you can go fairly indirect. Be completely conversational, completely fun and self-amusing. Recognize that you can show intent later, you don't have to fuck the girl in 5 minutes, and trust that you as a man are enough. If you show your personality long enough, she has no choice to be into you. However, if you go direct and then indirect, you're fucked. Think how incongruent it is to be like, you are fucking hot. I love you, I wanna talk to you. So how's the weather? Right? It's fucking stupid, you can't do that. It's also weird to be like, hey, so do you know how to get to 55th Street? Oh, and by the way, sorry, I just happened to notice randomly, you're just really hot, right? It doesn't work. Make a decision and commit. What this really comes down to, I guess, is congruence, right? What a lot of what girls are looking for in a guy is she's looking for the man to be congruent. She's looking for the man to be true to himself and true to what he believes. And if you start one way and go another way, you're essentially proving to her, beyond a doubt, that you are an incongruent man. How could she be attracted to that? It just doesn't make sense. That's why it's so important to be decisive, pick one route, and walk that path. Example number three. Should you stay in the set? Should you bounce? When is it time to leave? How long should you stay in the set? Well, here's the thing. Well, first of all, it depends on what your objective is, and we'll get to that in one of these other categories later, but here's the other thing. It doesn't really matter so much whether you stay in the set or whether you bounce in terms of making your night great, but it does matter that you make a clear distinction. The worst decision you can make is to stay in a set half-assed. To stay in a set and be thinking, oh, I don't really want to be here, but it's the warm end of the pool. It's easier than going back and opening a new set. It's easier than taking the risk. Or to be thinking, you know, this girl's really not that hot. If I pull her, yeah, it'll be a pull, it'll be a victory, but I wouldn't really be that into it, right? Instead, it's better for the soul to go after that hot girl that scares you and get blown out than it is to pull the girl you know you can get. It is better for your soul. Trust yourself and believe in the abundance of your future and take that risk. That's what a champion would do. Next topic is one I actually don't get asked, and I probably should get asked. And that is, when a girl that you're dating or that you're seeing on some level is getting out of line, what do you do? Do you tolerate her behavior and just be the non-needy, laissez-faire guy that doesn't give a fuck? Or do you put your foot down and draw a hard line and be aggressive and dominant and alpha? And this is a really, really difficult question for a lot of guys. And this is a situation where a lot of guys lose their girls. And in fact, probably the most painful night I have ever had in my entire life came from me getting this particular question wrong. There's a situation where the girl I was dating was hanging out with some other guy, and I decided to be non-needy to a fault, and then I got a little needy, and then I got non-needy again, and then she ended up basically going home with the guy and fucking him. And it was one of the most painful nights I've ever had in my entire life. And the thing is this, you have to make a decision. You must make a decision. Either you're in an open relationship with a girl and she can do what she wants and you just fucking tolerate it and let it be and laissez-faire, or you set your ground rules and you stick to them, right? And you must be absolute though. If you're wishy-washy, if you don't know what the rules are, if you haven't conveyed the rules to the girl, if she doesn't know what to expect from you in a relationship, how is she supposed to comply? How is a girl supposed to be good to you in a relationship if you haven't told her what being good to you in a relationship is, if you haven't made that clear? It is your job as a man to lead, and it is your job to know when to put your foot down and when not to. And most importantly, don't put your foot down half-assed. If you set a rule with a girl, be like, no, that's wrong, we don't do that. Don't be like, well, you know you did this, and I think that maybe next time you should maybe do a little less, but I mean, I'm kind of not sure, because if you're unsure, first of all, she'll have no fucking respect for you whatsoever, and you'll probably lose her on that. But secondly, if you're unsure, how's she gonna be sure? How is that gonna be effective? Make a decision. And again, it almost doesn't matter what your rules are, but it does matter that you know them, that you're clear about them, and that you stick to them. Two more great examples of this topic. Firstly, dating. I have a rule. You don't have to follow this rule. This is my particular rule, and it works for me. I don't accept dates on any terms other than my own. I found great success at this rule. And now, why do I do this? Number one, because I've gotten to a level, thankfully, in my game where I have abundance in my dating. I have abundance where I'm double or triple booked most nights if I want to be, where I actually am like trying to get rid of girls more than I'm trying to keep them around. So that helps. But here's the thing. If I, on a particular evening, take a date with a girl halfway between my house and her house, the odds of me sleeping with her on that date are actually quite low. Even with excellent game, it's just logistically difficult, because at some point there's going to be that awkward decision where she has to justify that if you really like her, you probably could just take her on another date. And it's awkward because she's going to go to her place, you're going to go to your place, you have two cars maybe. It's just a pain in the ass. And at some point, the date is probably going to falter. But many guys are so caught up on one girl, or so into getting the date, or so into making it work, that they'll take that date, that half-assed date, and then they'll end up getting in the dating frame, taking many, many dates, or end up getting a situation where it doesn't sexually escalate, or at the very least, wasting their time. What will I do? If I ask for a girl to come to a specific location and she doesn't want to come to that location, if she starts giving me shit about it, I will say, oh, well, listen, it sounds like you're really busy that night. Maybe we should just do it some other time, right? Where did I learn this? Girls. This is what girls do, right? Girls will take the date with you if it's convenient. They won't if it's not convenient. And I'm not saying adopt the behavior of a flaky girl. I'm not saying that a flaky girl should be your role model in life, because that's a pretty fucked up way to live your life. But the fact of the matter is, it's effective. Because when a girl does that, if you really like her, if a girl says, no, I can't do it tonight, will you do it another night? Are you really going to not follow up with a girl you really like under that context? Are you really going to be put off by that if she's suggesting alternate plans? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. And what does it convey? It conveys that she has other things going on in her life. She's cooler than you. It makes you wonder if she actually really likes you. It puts you in your head. All right? You can do the same thing to a girl. And what I found is a lot of really hot girls will do that. They'll set the date. They'll put a lot of obstacles to dating them, i.e. come to my neighborhood, do it on my terms. And if you just give them this, oh, listen, it sounds like, I mean, I totally want to see you, but it sounds like you're busy. No big deal. I'll just do my thing. Maybe we can do something another time. And the girls have respect for that, because who does that? The high quality alpha guys who have better things to do. And a lot of times I've had girls come around and be like, no, we can do it your way. Or I've had girls actually make the plan later and then be super, super on, or they start like chasing me super hard in text and phone game because I stood up to them and I made that strong decision, right? So again, don't take it on any terms other than your own. Last example of this, and maybe one of the most obvious examples, comes down to physical touch. Okay? When you touch a girl, you can touch a girl or you cannot touch a girl, but don't you ever dare half touch a girl. It comes down, I guess, similar to the metaphor I gave at the beginning of when you make love to a girl, you do it as hard and as well as you can. Think about it before, think about it after, but do it as hard as well as you can. So as an example of this, there's this physical move that many of you are probably familiar with called the claw, which is basically you reach out, you grab the girl, pull her into you, and start the conversation that way. Hey, you, come here, pull her in, you're fucking hot. Very dominant, very aggressive, very assertive. Now, where can you fuck up with the claw? Easiest way to fuck up with the claw is to do it half-assed, okay? If you grab her and pull her like, hey, maybe come, please come here, that doesn't work. You have to fucking grab it, pull it, and believe that she'll be okay with it. And be willing to accept the fact that she may blow up. Be willing to accept an angry response from her rather than no response for her. It's easy to fail big. There's this great phrase, a great phrase for game. Any mistake you make through audacity can be corrected through more audacity. Any mistake you make through timidity will not be forgiven. Very, very, very fucking true in game. Okay, you can always apologize for being over the top. You can never go back and say, no, I really am a man. I really am confident. You can never do that. You can always be overconfident and apologize. You can never be underconfident and bring it around later. Or it's fucking hard, so for all practical purposes, treat it like it's never, okay? So you gotta commit, you gotta grab. One minor thing, this is unrelated to the video topic, but if you do the claw and pull her in, don't hang on with the jaws of life, please. Once she's there, let her go, let it be loose. Like, just relax it in your hand, and then if you have to pull her back and commit again. It's a minor tip. Anyway, the point is, commit, be strong in whatever you do in game. It doesn't matter what you do, it matters the subcommunication of what you do. Why is this? Well, as human beings, we respond emotionally first through our reptile brain, our mammal brain, and lastly only through our human brain. And so the content, the making the right decision, the having the right box on the multiple choice test, that only satisfies the human brain. But committing, doing it with authority, doing it like you believe it, that satisfies the reptile brain, the mammal brain, the animal brain, which is what will get you laid. Because when a woman's getting laid, believe you me, she's an animal. All right, that's it. Commit. Take care.